Hi. Welcome to Ériu Dance Company's online presentation for this year's Féile Álainne an Ariagail. My name is Breandán and I'm Artistic Director of Ériu, a company that I established in 2010 with the aim to present a distinctive approach to the traditional arts, particularly dance. Having been lead dancer with Riverdance for almost a decade, I was privy to the culture and politics of the commercial Irish dance show, their artistic motivations, and who was permitted to make these creative choices. I felt that many were quite similar in terms of structure and purpose, and many followed similar approaches to presenting dance and music. Whilst these shows were an amazing opportunity for me and many like me, and still are, I felt the need to work differently and to challenge the perception of how Irish dance was expected to be presented and what it could achieve in terms of audience engagement. With Ériu, I wanted to create shows that could have a clear narrative, or indeed no narrative at all, to be abstract and thought-provoking. I wanted to work with all types of music and collaborate with a host of artists of different disciplines. My aim was to promote Irish dance as a living, ever-evolving tradition, to explore the traditional aesthetic and to exploit the untapped poetic and dramatic possibilities of the genre, and to create inspiring new work. An important motivation was to move away from the revue-style structure which many of the mainstream shows follow. To date, we have created 7 productions, from solos to large ensemble works to dance films, and collaborated in several with other companies. We also have 2 works in development, one in partnership with the Earagail Arts Festival. That particular production, Balor na Súile, Nimhe, or Balor of the Evil Eye, is for our Donegal-based youth company, Nimhe, and we hope to launch at next year's festival, pandemic permitting. But I'll explain more about that later. Nocta was the first professional show I created, and it launched Ériu. The Irish word Nocta means to bear or to reveal all. The production allows the audience to get under the skin of those who inhabit this Irish dance world and gives them a glimpse of what it is that matters to them. With 3 central characters, each disenfranchised in their own way, the show seeks to address the marginalised who are forced to occupy uncomfortable spaces where they are expected to conform. In Nocta, we push the boundaries both of the Irish dance aesthetic, exploring new expressive possibilities, and also the context, how the Irish dance scene was situated in the show narrative. The dancers used their bodies differently, danced to a variety of musical styles, and performed characters, speaking as well as moving. It was a large-scale production with 16 on stage in New York. We were fortunate to have been supported by RTE when creating the show. They shot a 6-part documentary series called Dance Off, documenting the making of Nocta. The show had its first performance in Belfast in August 2010. In April 2011, we toured Ireland, and in September of that year, Nocta completed a 5-week residency in the Irish Repertory Theatre in New York, supported by Culture Ireland. The following year, we were delighted to hear that we were shortlisted for 2 Drama Desk Awards in New York, Unique Theatrical Experience and Outstanding Choreography.
Me to the thought when he sings it.
From a personal perspective, an important point of departure for Ériu's second production, The Rite of Spring, was the old Irish saying, Na gen nos, na brish nos, which translates as, don't make a custom, don't break a custom. Whereas I always felt it should be, gen nos, brish nos, make a custom, break a custom. Stravinsky's seminal work, Rite of Spring, is considered to be one of the great pieces of music of the 20th century. A ballet so revolutionary that it's claimed that it caused riots when it was first performed in Paris in 1913, and it continues to challenge and inspire audiences to this day. Indeed, the Rite of Spring is a rite of passage for many choreographers to do something that might never have been attempted before. The piece is a massive undertaking. Puccini described the music as the work of a madman. The score is primordial and elemental, brimful of polytonality, dissonance, and barbaric rhythms. The scenario is a pagan ritual with a very chilling closing movement in which a sacrificial virgin dances herself to death, or in our version, dances himself to death. I was intrigued by the original story and how its gruesomeness highlights our own very real and very human evil urges, and that we're all capable of such wickedness. The premiere of Ériu's risque interpretation of the rite coincided with the 100th anniversary of this groundbreaking work, opening Fleahiol na Héireann in Cavan in 2012. Our version, performed in front of Cavan Cathedral, included both Irish and aerial dancers, accompanied by internationally acclaimed pianists Michael Joyce and Sabine Ducroix. With novel approaches to Irish dance vocabulary and challenging the canons of the Irish dance aesthetic in areas such as verticality, we married traditional and modern art forms and added unprecedented elements to this extraordinary music. An artistic aim was to focus on a more visceral aesthetic, to unleash the human in the dancer, allowing those impulses to activate the dancing body on surfaces with expressive gestures rarely found in present-day Irish dance. It's a show about mob mentality, about standing behind others for fear of being made the target. It makes us confront our reluctance to stand up and take charge of our feelings, our thoughts, our values, and demands that we let ourselves be seen, regardless of the consequences. At the heart of the show is the notion of breaking with tradition, creating new ones, and allowing them to be broken too. One of Ériu's most featured dancers is Nick O'Connell. He performed The Chosen One, which is the principal role in Rite of Spring. His performance was so powerful and emotive, not just for me, but for Nick himself, that I was compelled to make a show about those haunting and poignant outcomes. Linger is a contemporary Irish dance duet for two male dancers at opposite ends of their dancing careers. This immersive work addresses identity, aging and sexuality, and unfolds through a rich tapestry of music, movement, life drawing, photography and film. The show also deals with the subjective experience of time. Linger is a mediation on masculinity, a concept that can mean many things, and it aims to leave the viewer a little closer to understanding its complexity. Considerable sections of the show include the deliberate choreographic choice of both performers dancing in unison, which Jane Berg interpreted so brilliantly in reviewing Linger at the Edinburgh Fringe. This simple contrast of sameness difference is complex terrain for the subconscious to contemplate whilst being transported by a choreography of breathtaking unison. Teacher, pupil, father, son, lovers, or perhaps the same person, the sensitivity of the work encompasses all these possibilities. This duality, mentor, apprentice, lovers, the same person at different times, reinforces the aim to conjure a sense of being neither here nor there, as Heaney puts it, a division into two states. Linger harnesses this contrast, the mercurial movements of youth juxtaposed with the more considered gestures of the less young, making us reflect on the passage of time and who we are at different junctures of our lives. We were thrilled when Linger was shortlisted for a Total Theatre and the Place Award for Dance at the Edinburgh Fringe in 2016. Just as Linger was a sort of postscript to Rite of Spring, Linger itself left us with some concepts that we felt ought to be explored, one of which was authentic identity and led to the next show. A key question that arose was, who am I? The me I let you see? We acknowledge that we all construct identities in an undisclosed dialogue with the communities around us. Our lively company discussions led to an agreement that performing versions of ourselves that others might be more comfortable with is a very human instinct. And we do this in an effort to belong, but at the expense of our real selves. We decided to frame the show, which we called Éin, which is Irish for one or single, in today's digital age, where the orders of the day are uploaded personal profiles more in line with who we think we should be, rather than who we really are. The show is not a critique of the network society, nor does it bemoan the negative attributes of the internet. The culture of the technological age simply brings this behaviour into sharper focus. To create a unique movement vocabulary for Éin, we harnessed postures and idiosyncrasies associated with the new media age. Our body language is stooped and inward-looking, which belies that which the characters communicate online. An aspirational, perfect me, a brand imagined, constructed, and broadcasted. Eventually, each archetype confronts the delusion of presenting themselves as someone slightly better and comes to terms with who they really are, throwing off their masks, shedding their armor, and joining in a dance of liberation. Ain is about identifying who we really are, and at the heart of that is connection. Connection is what gives purpose and meaning to our lives. Ain challenges us to fully embrace vulnerability and then to strive for a sense of worthiness, to be willing to let go of who we think we should be in order to be who we are. Chaste is a dance film set on a bog in the mountains of Ireland. One of the questions we were exploring was, how would the Irish have danced if our history had unfolded differently? If we were truly free, free to allow the urges and desires that are born deep inside the dancer to surface on the body unimpeded. Our visual inspiration for the film was Caravaggio's painting, The Taking of Christ. Treated simply and non-religiously, as a group of people engaged in a specific act, members of a pack, hunting, always hungry, always searching. Director Michelle Manahan writes, "We find the dancers out on the bog, free, squelching sounds of bare feet sinking into brown, sodden earth, in a wind that howls over an old landscape, a landscape that will give up its secrets about who we are and who we have been, if we dig deep enough into the land and into the body." Chaste was a winner in the My Dance Film competition at the 2019 Dance on Camera Festival in New York, and as such was screened at the Lincoln Center as part of the festival.
Thank you.
Logan Gaelic agus glua sharta at a siliru shot the hodge eru the hair grama Oscar Wilde Salome. A run mid a go for it la tiger the galiva the brush oriarta ars na Gaelic. Oscar Wilde Salome speaks for itself. The classic, which was initially banned and still considered to be controversial, is not for the faint-hearted. A story with everything. Incest, pedophilia, murder, even necrophilia. It showcases evil as evil can be. For Eru's production, the text was translated into Irish, and through the body, voice and music, which are seamlessly united, each inciting and arousing the other, we created a dance work that is brutal and terrifying. The show was performed in An Taibhdheach at the Galway International Arts Festival in 2019. When I first heard Gina Borum sing, I marched straight up to her and I said, we have got to do a project together. We had just premiered Aine in Erchlangudor as part of the 2017 Ériu Arts Festival. And Gina, who's a friend of one of the Ériu dancers, sang a couple of Billie Holiday numbers at the closing night party. And she just literally blew me away. Our source material for Wall's talk was vast and it was quite a job distilling it into an hour-long show. We grappled with concepts such as species-wide consciousness, genetic memory, even quantum theory, to name just a few. The work explores the notion of memory being captured or recorded in the material world around us. All our actions, our feelings and thoughts frozen in matter and energy for eternity. The songs were blues and jazz classics and set in a Liederkreis structure. We describe the show as an abstract assemblage of fragments, from the music, song and dance representing many different genres, to the text and the mise-en-scène, all diverse and contrasting, yet this chaotic cacophony making unexpectedly harmonious bedfellows. Just the memory of it, that's all you have now, just the memory. And even now, even so soon,
It has been distilled of all its coarseness. And what's left is going to be precious, precious gold.
Hello, my love. It's getting cold on this island. I'm sad alone.
Ériu, Curtis Paul, encountering Sumari for almost ever frozen capsules of water, gushing, beautifully rank, finally free, freedom, finding its own level.
I needed the support of the world. With nowhere to go, we're going nowhere.
Just the memory of it. That's all you have now.
And going there real slow, knowing you wouldn't be there. No, the whiskey didn't help at all. In fact, it even made me crawl. I needed the support of the wall.
And what's left? It's going to be precious, precious gold.
If you had stayed with me, my fiery lover.
One of our two new works in development is The Village, and we're doing this in partnership with the Town Hall Theatre in Galway. When I was exploring ideas of what to do for 2021, I realised that it was Nocturne's 10-year anniversary, and I thought it might be nice to do something that emanated from the same source. At its core, Nocturne is an archaeology of the self, an unearthing of a personal narrative. Like Salome, The Village will be a play with music and dance. We've been exploring approaches to presenting both the voice and movement in unison. A stylized presentation, not necessarily based on reality, but feeling inevitable. For this project, we're drawing on our habitus. French philosopher Pierre Bourdieu suggests that the habitus is what organises us socially. It explains how our likelihood to behave in certain ways is dependent on how we expect others to respond. A sinister and intriguing story, The Village sees five people gather on a hill overlooking the townland where they all grew up. As they watch the lights go out over the village, it's not clear what brings them together here now, or what connects them other than the village.
Thank you.
Our newest initiative is Nimhe, which is the youth branch of Ériu and is Donegal based. We're developing a show in partnership with the Earagail Arts Festival and had hoped to have workshops and an informal sharing of work in progress at this year's festival, but we had to postpone because of the pandemic. All going well, we will launch the company and premiere the inaugural work, Balor and the Súile, Nimhe, in Earagail Arts at next year's festival. The dance show, which is based on the ancient Donegal myth of Balor of the Evil Eye, provides a professional platform for the young, talented dancers and eventually musicians from the region, and involves training, mentorship and professional performance opportunities. The long-term goal is to present a new work at the Earagail Arts Festival every year or two, and to tour the company nationally and internationally. We'll finish up now with some early exploratory work that I did in Balor, but before that, thanks a million for watching, and we hope to see you at the premiere of Balor at the Earagail Arts Festival in the not-too-distant future. Go míle maith agat. Thank you.
We'll be right back.